Show!
Few things bring as much joy to the Mr. Men and Little Misses as their cars. Out on the open road with the wind blowing through whatever hair they may have, the good people of Dillydale know how to get somewhere quickly and comfortably.
Oh, what a terrible day for driving. Too much sun and all this traffic. Oh, would it be so hard to make a car seat as comfortable? Now what? Great. Suddenly there's not a car in sight. How am I going to get left home?
Hi there, Mr. Grumpy.
Oh, great. Miss Sunshine. Isn't my day bad enough?
Is there something wrong with your car? Or is your engine getting a suntan?
Apparently my engine has overheated.
I have no idea what that means. I'm not mechanical. But do you want to live back into town?
Do I go with her or stay and get pecked by hungry buzzards? I think I'll stay.
But how will you get back into town?
You've made your point.
Hop in. It's lucky I came along.
I'll be the judge of that. Why aren't we moving?
Because you're not wearing your seatbelt. Isn't it a beautiful day?
Keep your eyes on the road.
Look at those farms.
They smell.
And all the animals.
They smell worse.
What about...
Don't care for them neither.
How did you know what I was going to say?
Doesn't matter. Drive. Can you roll up the window and turn on the air conditioning?
I don't have air conditioning. I like feeling the wind in my face. Oh, how about some music? I think the radio makes the trip so much more fun.
You took the words out of my mouth.
Get down, the boogie's got me.
I don't like that song.
Oh, I'm the one that got the big miss.
I like this one even less. Stop the car.
Oh, what happened?
Nothing. I suddenly had the urge to get a little exercise. I'll walk home from here.
Okie dokie. Great travelling with you.
It's just so unnatural to be that happy.
Okay, Dillydale Choir Club, ready to rehearse?
Be it sail, whale, quail or nightingale, everything was happy in Dillydale. There's never any reason to be crabby, bad or grumpy, unless you're a certain Mr. Grumpy.
Oh, crooked cucumbers!
Thank you for letting me be your assistant, Miss Scary. I love helping.
After the race, I just might let you help me wash the car.
I bet this big truck is a little much for you, Mr. Strong?
Not really. Piece of cake, Mr. Rude.
Good tidings, fellow competitors.
You guys don't have a chance against my rocket racer. It's got the power of 800 horses.
Whilst that may be true, this car has the power of a one-legged ostrich.
Mr. Small is right. Have you ever tried to catch a one-legged ostrich? Oh, they're fast.
Fast? I'll show you fast.
Mr. Rude!
Miss Delaval.
Mr. Men and Little Misses, start your engines! Ready, steady!
Oh, 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 oh.
like my engine's knocking. That could be trouble. Maybe if I speed up.
Good morning, Mr. Stubborn. I understand you have a car for sale.
I do.
Well, I'm looking to buy a car. Something clean and well-maintained, preferably as a color blue with a gray interior.
I have just the car for you.
Oh, goody. I knew this would be my lucky day.
The car is in perfect condition.
Perfect? Well, then why are you selling it?
Why should I keep all the good cars for myself?
Very generous of you. Well, where is it? All I can see is a rusty old wreck.
That is not a rusty old wreck. That's the car for sale.
But it's disgusting.
Try to contain your enthusiasm. Come, let's take it for a test drive.
That's not necessary, Mr. Stubborn.
You must test drive a car before buying one. Don't you know anything? Here, catch!
The steering wheel feels a little loose, not to mention covered in grease and grime.
That isn't grease and grime.
And half this pedal is missing.
It is not missing. It's just small.
No, I can clearly see where the pedal snapped in half.
You are wrong!
The speedometer must be broken. It says we're going 100 miles an hour.
There's nothing wrong with that speedometer.
It just doesn't seem like we're going that fast.
Of course we are. They don't build them like this anymore.
What about all that black smoke?
What smoke?
The smoke pouring from the exhaust.
That lets you know the engine is working well.
Ooh! This is the worst car I have ever seen.
Well, if that's your attitude, I'm not selling it to you.
Good.
I would give it away before I'd let you buy it.
Well, that's fine, because I don't want it.
I promise you, you are the one person on Earth who will never, ever own this car.
Hold it right there. I have every right to buy that horrible machine, and that's just what I'll do.
No.
Yes.
No, I will not sell you this car.
I insist you sell me this car. Now, Mr. Stubborn, let this be a lesson to you. The customer is always right.
The customer is always cheap.
Here you go, Mr. Bem.
Thanks, Miss Whoops. Who did you say was coming to take me home?
Mr. Scatterbrain.
Oh, maybe I should have called a cab.
Don't be silly. Mr. Scatterbrain's a very good driver.
Sorry I'm late. I had to return a wrench to a monkey.
Take good care of yourself, Mr. Bem.
See you, fella. Here you go, Mr. Bump.
Are you sure this isn't too much trouble for you?
Oh, no trouble at all.
Ow!
It's good to know those still work.
Red light, Mr. Scatterbrain! Red light!
Oh, I love this game! One, two, three, red light!
No, no! Hands on wheel!
I usually don't pick up hitchhikers, but who can refuse a chicken?
Stop! Chicken!
Well, seems it never pays to make a chicken mad.
No!
Am I?
Well, you're home!
Thank goodness! Thanks for the lift, Mr. Scatterbrain. I'll never forget it.
Okay, Mr. Bump. Anytime.
No. You never learn.
And so it is that in Dillydale, no matter if you like to creep along slowly or zoom super fast, everyone loves driving cars. Of course, some cars are more fun to drive than others.